I a bit about the Korg synthesizer. So my previous video about it had a huge success, totally unexpected, because as I learned, this thing is the holy grail of vintage electronic music. And my video was even featured on the Korg Facebook feed. So it is quite nice. And yes, I will restore it, as it is. It seems extremely rare and extremely wanted. So it is in working condition, which is a good news, but it needs some overhaul anyway. What do we have to do? So I will start easy. With cleaning, removing and cleaning all the buttons with soap, soapy water and toothbrush. Also the side panels need to be cleaned. Then I will separate the two parts. In fact, there is the bottom part with the keyboard and the top part with the electronics, which is quite a pain because in fact the electronics are prisoner in this V-shaped metal piece. And we cannot remove the back panel here to have a good access to electronics. So it will be quite complicated at this point. So about the keyboard, I will try to see if I can clean it without undoing each one of the keys, because as it is old, the plastic may be brittle and I do not want to break any part. So probably it will go into good pressure of shower with soap and tedious cleaning of everything, but without removing the keys by themselves. The bottom metal piece so needs a good cleaning and probably a new paint. I guess it deserves it because the paint is really sad and there is rust, in fact, everywhere under the paint. So I will clean it with iron wool probably to remove a maximum amount of rust and then do a coat of paint on it. About the top part, so this front piece, the paint is not too bad. But it is very rusty on the top here, so I will probably paint only the top. I will protect this piece, this front panel, and I will redo the paint only on the top. And for the back, there is the original marking which I want to keep. So I will probably cover this and do the remake the paint everywhere else. Let me know what you think about these plans. It is not started yet anyway, so I can still change my mind, but as you can see, there is rust here, here, scratches, so it deserves some new paint, new mains cable obviously. Try to save this original marking, of course. This manufacturer plate can be removed, so it is not a problem. About the electronics, the most of the work will be cleaning the potentiometers and the buttons. As it seems, some of them are noisy, not everyone. So it is good, they do not seem to be in too bad condition, but some of them definitely need cleaning. And I learned in a YouTube video that in fact, for doing music with this thing, you use the buttons as much as the keyboard. I was believing you set your tunes here and you play on the keyboard, but no, it is a thing of doing like so. Interesting. So, excuse me, the phone was ringing. So, the potentiometers and the switches seem to be in good condition. They are old school potentiometers with an opening in it, so I can spray some cleaner inside and it should be good. I need all this hardware here is quite rusty, so I will probably clean it with iron wool again, each one of these bolts. The jacks need the cleaning inside And apart from this, what else? I had a first look inside. The wire harnesses are quite messy, so I will tidy. Excuse me for the noise, it is a dog. I will tidy up the wire harnesses. I will check for all the solder joints and see if it is necessary or not to change the electrolytic capacitors. I will probably test some of them. If they test good, I will consider it is good enough. But if some of them test bad, I will see if I can replace them all. I do not know how many capacitors we have in this thing yet, because the circuit boards are along this front panel, and it is quite hard to see the components. The components are between the circuit boards and the front panel. So apart from this, I need also to find the user manual for it and service manual. Maybe it can help, but in fact it is quite straightforward for disassembling at least. But I need to learn a little bit how to use it. So I will wait a few more days maybe before starting, because I did order patch cables. I would like to receive them and test it with the patch cables before starting to take it apart. Because when it is in parts, I do not know how many times I will need to complete the restoration. I will need to get black paint. It seems it is shiny black paint. In fact, it is not really black, it is more dark gray, it seems. We need to investigate it a little bit in order to find correct paint, unless I manage to clean the rust and the paint is not too damaged apart from this, but I think it needs some paint. And also replacing some screws which are very rusty and damaged, but they are regular Japanese screws, so I have a stock of them, it should not be a problem. Okay, so there is a lot of dust inside here, it is quite incredible. I did as an FNC some bugs inside. No cockroach, but little things, spiders and such, so it really needs a good cleaning. And when the restoration is done, I do not know. As it is a rarity, I may keep it for myself, but in fact I do not have a big use for it. But if it is a museum piece, I will probably want to keep it, unless I got an interesting offer. I know there are lots of people interested by this, but for now I want to keep it and play with it a little bit. Okay, thanks for watching, bye bye.